Well, these are all arguments of convenience. Qua the Land Acquisition Act, they had one policy in Bhatta Persol, another policy as far as Ulawas and Gurgaon is concerned. Similarly, they want to go to the NDA ruled states or to a BSP ruled states and say that we have a right to protest. And whenever a protest is held in Delhi, you scuttle the protest by either using the police powers or by hitting lathis on the heads of people. That's what they've done.
The Congress alleges, Mr. Jaitley, that the BJP is simply indulging in politics. You yourself have several reservations with the Lokpal bill in the way that Team Anna is projecting it. And because it is politically expedient at this time, you are supporting Anna Hazare, who the Congress alleges is blackmailing the government and really threatening our democracy.
But tell me, is any form of protest, whether it's a demonstration or a fast, is it necessarily a blackmail? Gandhiji went on fast all his life. Morarji Desai went on a fast in 1975 to force an election in the state of Gujarat. We've had politicians going on fast on several occasions. We've had other activists going on fast. Well, these fasts are an essence of protest. If you find that law is being broken, please step in. But if law is not being broken at any stage, please allow some space for dissent in a democracy. If you scuttle the space for dissent in a democracy, you are going to render Indian democracy much weaker than what it is.
Do you believe the Home Minister, Mr. Jaitley, when he says that all decisions taken this morning were taken purely administratively by the Delhi police and the government had nothing to do with the decisions that the police commissioner was taking?
I think this is an argument of cowardice. It's an argument where the Home Minister hides behind the man in uniform and says, well, it's his decision, not mine. Now, does the police commissioner, is he willing to lay down a permanent condition in Delhi that nobody will ever have a protest of more than 5,000 people? It's absolutely anachronic in present day to say that the size of the protest will be regulated by the government. If the political sins of this government are too large, the size of the protest will be much bigger.
No, but do you not think, from a practical perspective, that some of the demands being made by Anna Hazare are very difficult to implement? They will lead to a subversion of our constitutional system of democracy and will require changes to the constitution which are very difficult to actually implement, Mr. Jaitley. You know, in all this din, those facts seem to be forgotten.
Well, I don't think the content of the Lokpal bill is the issue today. I have serious differences with the bill prepared by the government. I may have some differences with the law prepared by Shri Anna Hazare. I may have a third point of view, but I am willing to concede with people with a different point of view also the right to campaign on their point of view. I disagree with them, but I have a right to concede to them their right to disagree with me and their right to protest. Even if we disagree with Anna Hazare or with the government, I am equally willing to uphold the Congress party's right to support the government bill and Anna Hazare's right to campaign on his bill.
So what
we
happens?
Can't snatch away the right. If we take away the right to protest, if we take away the right to dissent, we'll end up making India a banana republic.
Mr. Jaitley, what happens from here? Left parties want a 3-day boycott of parliament. Will the BJP be supporting that? Do you see any scope for further negotiations with Team Anna? Do you see some common ground being found, Mr. Jaitley?
No, we've all had a parliamentary coordination meeting of various opposition parties, and by unanimity, finally everybody has agreed. We will be vigilant, we will be in the house, we will demand that these arrests should be immediately revoked and the arrested people should be released. We will demand that these people have a right to protest peacefully, and we will demand that with the kind of subversion of democracy that has taken place, the Prime Minister must make a statement before both houses of parliament and answer the questions which the opposition